So I got this book here, Larry J. Sobato, A More Perfect Constitution, 23 Proposals to Revitalize Our Constitution and Make America a Fairer Country. 23 proposals. So I'm just going to actually give you the meat and potatoes of the whole damn thing. Sorry, the meat and potatoes. Build a more representative Senate by granting 10 states with the greatest population, 2 additional senators in the next 15 states, 1 additional senator each. So this is proposals for revising the Constitution, Chapter 1, creating a capital Congress. Granting the 10 states with the greatest population, 2 additional senators and senators, and the next 15 states, 1 additional senator each. Under this proposal, the District of Columbia would also finally receive its own voting representation in the Senate. Number 2, appoint all former presidents and vice presidents to the new office of national senator. Number 3, mandate nonpartisan redistricting for House elections. This single reform, if properly implemented, could significantly enhance electoral competition. National senator, what the hell does that do? Well, you're a former president, well, that makes you a national senator. You're a former vice president, that makes you a national senator. And what is a new office of national senator? We don't need more senators. We need less senators. I got one. Let's get rid of the Senate. That would be my first fucking suggestion. Let's get rid of the Senate. And then let's post a new 21st century Bill of Rights. We'll keep all the rights that we got in the Constitution now, but let's add all the other rights. I mean, all these states have all these additional freedoms. You got more freedoms. You got, you know, right to food and water, right to privacy, right to unionize. Those aren't included. And, you know, there's a resistance to oppression, a whole bunch of shit. The states and the other countries of the world, in addition to the rights of man. In addition to the rights of man. That's kind of an interesting idea, more representative Senate, but that's the whole point, was that the states, it was a collection of states by making it, you know, expanding the Senate to the proportion of the population. That's more of the House. So you're changing how the change congressional terms by lengthening House terms to 3 years and setting all Senate terms to coincide with each presidential election. The entire House and Senate would be elected anytime the presidency was contested on the ballots. I think those are like good ideas. A lot of these are good ideas, but it's not big enough, you know? 3 years, I don't know. The House terms, 2 years. It's like every other fucking setting all Senate terms to coincide with each presidential election. That would help the turnout rate for the Senate elections. The entire House and Senate would be elected anytime the presidency was contested on the ballot. Expand the size of the House to approximately 1,000 members so that representatives, the people need to go vote, even in midterm elections. I know it's not the fucking president, but it's the governor. And the governor is your president of your state, you stupid motherfuckers. Expand the size of the House to approximately 1,000 members. I like that a lot. Get rid of the Senate and expand the House to 1,000 members. The Senate, they're the House of Lords, right? That's the elites. But it's our country, right? That's how our country tis of thee. That's how the Republic works, to form a more perfect union. Expand the House. Maybe you should break up the more popular states, the states that have all the population. Maybe their goddamn state's too fucking big. Break them up. Break them up in a couple smaller states, and then you can have 2 senators with each of, you know, California major, California minor. The staffing and budget levels, establish generous term limits for representatives and senators, thus restoring the founders' favorite principle of frequent rotation in office. Generous term limits. Generous. He's saying like pass term limits out for anybody and everybody. So you get to be a House rep for 3 years and you get to something else for 15 years. But just for one goddamn term. And then you got to get the fuck out. I don't know. I kind of go back and forth. I like term limits because we need new blood in there. But really, it's the American people need to get more active in their politics, in their government. More generous term limits. The elections are term limits. Add a balanced budget amendment with appropriate safeguards and escape clauses in order to encourage fiscal fairness to future generations. Create a continuity of government procedure that would allow for the gubernatorial appointment of deceased representatives to the House until a special election can be held. Permit the temporary appointment of replacement legislators if elected representatives and senators are incapacitated, and require members of Congress to draw up a secession list upon their election from which their replacement would be drawn to avoid unhelpful political maneuvering at a time of national crisis. Those are interesting ideas. I like the balanced budget amendment, the continuity of government. I'm not, right? Establish a new 6-year presidential term. See, we're expanding presidential terms. We're expanding House terms. 3 years now, but just 2 terms. That's it. A new 6-year presidential term. 6 years, fucking too much. That's too much. If anything, we should just make the president 1 year, including a 5th year extension referendum. A 5th year extension referendum that is an up or down confirmation election, which could result in additional 2 years in office for the president. In the event of a no confidence vote from the American public, a new national election featuring candidates from both political parties would be held. So they're kind of trying to be like England, right? Get a no confidence vote from America the 5th year. And then what? It'll be 8 years. I guess that's all they get is 8 years. So that's interesting. Perfecting the presidency. This is chapter 2. Limit some presidential war-making powers and expand Congress's oversight of war-making, particularly through extending, toughening, and incorporating into the Constitution the kind of regime envisioned by the War Powers Resolution of 1973. I like that. Congress is supposed to declare the war. So I don't even see how the president is declaring the war. It's Congress is supposed to. So they're just not enforcing their own powers. Give the president a line item veto to remove specific items from appropriations bills. That's a lot more power to the president. Line item veto, so they could say, no, Sally Joe Raphael cannot get that $5 new chair mug. Nope, Sally doesn't get that $5. Where's that $5 note? I'll pass the budget without that $5 going to Sally. You don't like Sally or hate Sally. I hate her. Replace the unfair constitution. You don't know all the things that she has said and done. You don't know the whole. Replace the unfair constitutional prohibition against non-natural born presidents with the requirement that a candidate for presidency or vice presidency need only to have been a U.S. citizen for 20 years. So Arnold Schwarzenegger can go ahead and run. This perfects the presidency. He doesn't mention ranked choice voting. America's elections are nearly perfect. Gerrymandering is a big thing. So actually, number 3, mandate nonpartisan redistricting for House elections would help a bunch. Chapter 3, the new court, supreme but not eternal, eliminate lifetime tenure in favor of a single non-renewable term of 15 years for all federal judges. Grant Congress the power to set mandatory retirement age for federal judges, including Supreme Court justice. Justices, expand the size of the Supreme Court bench from 9 to 12 to allow for a more representative high court. Give federal judges more financial independence with guaranteed cost of living increases. Congress would retain the power to raise judicial-based salaries as well. Chapter 4, Politics, America's Missing Constitutional Link. Write a new separate constitutional article specifically for the politics of the American system. The framers chose to avoid this topic, having not yet realized the importance of political parties to the structure of our elections by creating a rational presidential selection process and adding other needed political changes. The revised constitution could bring some much needed order out of the chaos that currently exists due to the lack of any substantive political guidance in the basic document of state. A separate constitutional article for the politics. I don't even adopt a regional lottery system for presidential party nominations to avoid the destructive front loading of primaries. The order of state nominating contests will be determined on January 1st of the election year, thus ending part of the permanent campaign for the White House. The primary process would also be restricted to the 4 months preceding the August nominating conventions, thereby sparing voters a year-long all-out campaign. 19, mend rather than end the electoral college by granting more populated states additional electors, essentially in proportion either to their population or to their enhanced U.S. Senate representation. This preserves the salutary effects of the Electoral College, such as isolating post-election recounts while minimizing the chances that a president will win the office without a plurality of the popular vote. In addition, faithless electors should be eliminated by making the position honorary and the exceptionally inequitable unit voting rule in the U.S. House for breaking electoral ties would be abolished in favor of one congressperson, one vote. 20, reform campaign financing by permitting by permitting Congress to pass reasonable limitations on campaign spending by the wealthy from their family fortunes and mandate partial public financing for general election, House and Senate campaigns. Number 21, adopt an automatic registration system for all qualified American citizens, thereby guaranteeing that the right to vote shall not be abridged because of unnecessary bureaucratic requirements. Chapter 5, a citizenship of service. Create a constitutional requirement that all able-bodied young Americans devote at least 2 years of their lives to the service of their nation, of course. Young Americans. Why not all Americans, you piece of shit? Even old people can. This universal civic duty would be, in essence, a bill of responsibilities to accompany the Bill of Rights. I like that idea. Attaching responsibilities to the rights. Hey, we need rights. Competency is important. And responsibility. And men want to be competent and responsible. A wide array of civilian and military options would be provided. Chapter 7, calling the 21st Century Constitutional Convention. Hell fucking yeah. In order to adopt the other 22 ideas, the country should convene a new constitutional convention using the state-based mechanism left to us by the framers in the current constitution. So I think that the way that you have to get a new constitutional convention is you have to have like two-thirds of the Congress call for it and then two-thirds of the states. Something fucking crazy like that. So it actually seems like it would be harder to get the permission from the fucking Congress to get it. The way that the first Continental Congress started, they just fucking started. So I bet you could do that too. Also, it started after the Articles of Confederation and they needed a rock star. So they went and tapped on George Washington's door, even though he had already retired from public service. So the rock star went to the Constitutional Convention. They wrote a new constitution. But people are like, well, what about the old constitution, the Articles of Confederation? Ah, fuck those articles. And then there was no Articles of Confederation. The majority of the convention voted for, the majority of the states ratified this shit. And then the Articles of Convention were no more. After, what, 13 of the 16, 17, Vermont, the Green Mountain Boys made sure that Vermont became its own state. It was the 14th state, I want to say. So you had the 13 original colonies, but Vermont and then Kentucky, right? Vermont, then Kentucky, 14, 15, something like that. Something like that. So yeah, we need a new constitutional convention. We need a 21st Bill of Rights. Bill of Responsibilities is interesting. Bill of Responsibilities, make sure you plant at least one tree per year. And we need to get rid of that damn Senate. Why do we have the fucking Senate? What the